Okay, so we are going to be beginning our home project drawings here. So the things that we need to begin with are we need to have our big paper with a half inch border drawn around the edges. And we need to have a photograph to use as our reference. And we also need to have a ruler. Very important things. So once you have your photograph in front of you and you're looking at it, you might be saying to yourself, how do I begin this? Where do I start? So what we're going to do is we're going to start just kind of thinking of this as a simple box shape and then adding a roof onto it. We're not going to worry about the windows yet. We'll get to those later, okay? So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to figure out where to start our box. And what I want to do is I want to look for the edge that is closest to the side. This one over here is a little bit closer to the side than that one. So the way that you're going to do this is you're going to estimate. You're going to look how far in that is and just kind of estimate on your drawing, on your paper, how far in that should be. So I'm going to make a little notch about there. And then I'm going to estimate how far up from the bottom that little corner is right there. And I'm going to look on my paper and I'm going to say if that's that far, I know it's a little bit lower than a half, about like halfway of the paper is probably about there. So I'm going to make the bottom of it about here. And then I'm going to make the top of it a little bit above half, so I'll make the top of it about there. I'm going to very lightly draw in a straight line here. And I'm doing it lightly because I might want to change that later. So make sure you use a ruler, but do it nice and lightly. We don't have to worry about vanishing points yet, although if I put my ruler on the bottom of that house, kind of going like that, and then I put my pencil on the top line of that house, we can see that our vanishing point is off of our paper. It's gonna be a little bit farther over about there on one side, and then on the other side, if we imagine a line going up like this, and then here it's a little bit trickier because we have that roof here, we don't have an actual straight line, but if I just kind of put it right on those windows right here, because that'll still count for a straight line. We can see that again, our vanishing point is just off of our paper over here on the other side. So we just want to kind of keep that in mind that our vanishing points are going to be off of our paper for now. So the next thing we're going to do is we've got our back end over here, and then now we're going to imagine where this point is on our drawing paper. So we want to just kind of estimate where that would be. And if you put your paper right in the center of your drawing, you can kind of get a sense of like how far over you want that to be. And I think I want to have mine be about that far over. And then we just want to estimate how far up that is going to be on our paper. And I think I'm kind of happy with something around here. So again, I'm going to make a very light line over here, like so. Now, I told you we're not worrying about vanishing points yet. We're going to in a moment, though. So now the next thing we want to do is we're just going to estimate again. And we're going to make a line going vertical up to show that side going up here. And again, we want to look and see about roughly how far down from the top is that end right there. And I'm going to say if I put that there, that'll give me about that much room for the roof. I think it'll be fine. So I'm going to make a line going up here, and I'm going to put it around that high. I ended up going a little bit lower just because it kind of felt like I wanted to go a little bit lower there. Where that scribble came from. So the next thing that we're going to do is we're now just going to be going down, connecting point to point over here. And again, if I kind of put my ruler on my pencil over here like that, and then I have this going up like this, I can see that these lines are going to meet up somewhere like around over here, which looked pretty similar to how they looked on my paper when I was finding my vanishing point on here, where those would meet up somewhere off the paper too. So I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to lightly connect my dots from here to here. Ruler, draw nice and lightly, because the chances of us erasing still are pretty high. It's somewhere along the line. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to, again, we need to make our the bottom of this side of our house. So we're going to imagine that line coming up like so over here. And then we need to think about how far over we need to go. So I'm going to figure out how far I need to make it. So if I look at that edge in relationship to the edge of my photograph, I think that when I put my, on my final drawing here, I think I'm going to make that about that far over, just so there's a touch more space on this side than there is on this side. Now, when I go to find this angle here, you can actually use your photograph to help you with the actual angles that we're drawing on here too, especially if we don't see our vanishing points on our paper. You can use your photograph to help out a lot. And one of the things that you can do is if you take your photograph and you line up the outside edge of the paper with the outside edge of your drawing paper, just so that your photograph is level with your drawing paper, you can put your ruler on, and I'm just kind of doing it right on the bottom edge of the house, and then I can compare that in the angle of this line with the angle of the line that I actually drew here, and it's pretty close. It doesn't have to be 100% exact most of the time, but you want it to be pretty close, okay? So if that is the same over here, then when I find this angle for the bottom part here, I want to keep something pretty similar. So I'm going to put my paper about here, and again, I'll just line up the outside edge with the paper, and then if I put my pencil here, and then I put my ruler down, I want my ruler to be about in line with where my pencil is, so I think I want an angle like that, so I know I'm starting it from that point, and I'm going only to that edge over here. So I'm just going to make a line like that, and again, I want to do it lightly because I may pull my paper up, and once I get everything in, I might decide that looks really weird, and I might want to change it. I'm now going to make a line going up, and I'm not going to worry too much about how high to make it yet. I just want to kind of have something going on over here for that. And then this angle here is pretty extreme. So what we're going to do is we've figured out this part right here is that part right here. So what we'll do is we'll make now, we'll kind of imagine a line that goes from this corner down into that little part right here. It's equivalent space on the other side over here. So again, if we put our pencil, if we put our paper up at the top and we line it up, the top of our photograph with the top edge of our drawing paper, I can put my pencil on connecting those two dots to kind of get the angle of that top edge. And then I want to do the same thing with my ruler. So I know I want my angle of this edge over here to be about like that. Now I'm going to do this lightly, but I think it's actually going to look pretty decent here. So I've got the main part of my house is kind of shaped like this here, which I think will work. So I'm just going to come down here, I'm going to erase. And I have the kind of general box-like shape. From here, we can then start to figure out where the roof is on here by making our X to figure out where our center is, drawing our line up, and then connecting our little triangles up here. If we look at this picture, we don't even actually see the very top part of that coming down because that part's over here is just a line, so it should be pretty simple. But you want to get to something kind of at this point today that we can then have kind of like the big structure that we can then start to add in other things like windows and decks and things like that too. All right, good luck.